I have always wondered what it looked like in a police car, and today I'm getting my chance to check one out. Don't worry, Mom, I'm not in trouble. We're here on P. Ecoy Street. We are chatting with Officer Jason Mike about their new radar that the HPD now has, a new and improved radar. Tell us all about it, Officer, and how it works.
Good morning. Well, we have the Stalker Dsr 2X radar, which is a great device that we're using and very user-friendly. It's a dual sensing radar. It can sense direction of which cars are going which direction. We have a total of two antennas. We have an antenna that's located on the rear deck of the vehicle that's able to sense the directions from the vehicles that's coming from the rear, able to pick up the speeds. And we also have a forward-facing antenna that's located on the dashboard. This, of course, is able to pick up any speeds of vehicles that are in the front of the vehicle. Both antennas are able to sense the speed and send it to the heads-up display unit, which is located on the dash for easy accessibility for the officer. There's a total of five windows on the device. The top two indicating the speed readings from the front antenna, and the bottom two indicating the speed readings from the rear antenna. The numbers in red indicate the fastest speed, the number in orange indicate the strongest signal. And then the other window indicates the patrol speed or the speed that the vehicle is going.
Okay, I also heard kind of a siren when I was sitting there. Is that part of the radar too?
Yeah, so there's an audio confirmation and a visual confirmation. As officers are driving along or sitting still, they're able to hear that confirmation of, hey, a vehicle is coming and it's picking up the speed reading.
Okay. How big of a problem is speeding in Hawaii? Is it a big problem?
Speeding is a very big problem here in Hawaii. You figure, looking back at the last federal fiscal year, 64,000 citations were issued among all islands, 40,000 of those being HPD. It's a very big problem. Even looking at 2015 statistics, 43% of our traffic fatalities were a result from speeding. So it's something that people are doing, and we're trying to get people to slow down to make the road safer, but also get people safer from point A to point B.
Absolutely. So how will these new radars help you with your job?
It makes us be more versatile. In areas where we weren't allowed to or able to do speed enforcement due to the fact of the roadway being too small or too narrow, now we can drive along in that traffic and be able to conduct speed enforcement and make that bit of roadway a little bit safer.
Joining me now is Sergeant Gabriel Kira. Now, Sergeant, you go to crash scenes all the time, right, to evaluate the evidence and to determine the factors that contributed to the crash. Can you tell us, how does speeding affect a crash?
Sure. The faster you go, the more tunnel vision you get, the narrower you have a field of view. Basically, at slow speeds, we have what's called peripheral vision. So you can see that person traveling next to you, you know, the bicyclist in the bikeway, the person trying to cross the road. But as you go faster, it basically becomes an exercise in collision avoidance. You're so focused on what's in front of you that you lose focus on what's on the side of you. And that's what causes accidents. Speed also takes away what's called time and distance. The faster you go, the less time you have to perceive and react to something. And that's what causes a lot of accidents that we see on the roadway.
All right. Did you hear that, people? Slow down, right? We want everybody to be safe and arrive alive. I have a question. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a general belief that police officers are out tagging drivers as a moneymaker. Tell me that's not true.
It's not true, Trini. There's a common misconception that all the money is collected from HPD through citations comes back to HPD. But there can be nothing further from the truth. All the citations that we issue, the money actually goes to the state into a general fund. And officers, believe it or not, do not enjoy issuing citations. I don't know if you've got one before, but it can be a very unpleasant experience for everybody involved, including the officers. So no, we don't like issuing citations. We would rather have the drivers follow the rules of the roadway.
Okay. Sadly, I do know how it feels, and it is unpleasant for everyone involved. So, Officer or Sergeant, thank you so much for talking with us today. So, Justin, the biggest difference is now the police cars will be able to be driving in traffic. You know, a lot of times they would normally be on the shoulder with their, you know, laser gun or the radar, but now they can actually be driving in traffic and see who's, you know, cars are going.
Technology is amazing. It's a new tool for their I like the name of it, Stalker. Stalker radar, right?
Right.
But it's cool. It's front, it's back, it's multiple cars that they can track. Yeah. And it's safer for them, quite frankly. Instead of being on the side of the road with a laser gun, you can be in the safety of the car.
So. And at the end of the day, what we're trying to do is just make the roads safer for everybody, right?
That's right. And remember, ticket money goes into the general fund for everything. It doesn't go back directly into HPD.
Yeah. There's that rumor going around, so I'm glad we
that was a great question.
Clear that up. Yeah. Okay.